Good morning, my friends. Back with another episode of Bigger Warriors 2 and the 1% Club. And I wanted to kind of do one this morning. I'm kind of waiting for a store to open. So I've gotten here early. This is probably around 5:30 or so. So hope you guys are doing well. Hope you guys are on your purpose. This is Saturday, I think it's November 12th. And hope everything is going according to your plan and you're keeping with your plan as far as our retention and continuing doing it. So thank you guys so much for your contributions and help, donations, all those type of things are always welcomed, and I appreciate those likes and comments. And we're up subscription wise, I think we're up to over 800 something, so thank you. I feel very blessed about that, and I appreciate all you guys. I also want to, we're also near 900 when it comes to NoFap and Monk Mode. I think we're over 100 and something, so I have to double check that. But as people say, this is kind of a lifestyle change, so I don't really keep track of it. I'm only doing it more for the channel and just let you guys see my development in age and reference so you can see the difference. And I know we've had a few people talking about that, and I can't remember who it was. I'm trying to go back to my notes a little bit here. But how different you look, and I think it was someone who was asking me about how long it takes to get the effects, because they were noticing in the effects and listening to me over time that you can see. So I think that I'm looking for this, but I can't find it right now. But I know they were talking about this difference. So anyway, thank you guys. I want to make some comments. Thank you about to people, Scott Allen. Thank you, Scott, for your comments. Isaac Flores. Thank you, Kevin. Corazon, is it? And I'm sorry if I mispronounced your name wrong. I apologize, but thank you, Kevin, for your comments. Thank you, Doug J, and also DSM Tech. We got some new ones coming with lifestyle change from DSM. He had some nice comments that I want to kind of comment on that at some point. I have about 35 of these that I gotta do for the next month or so. And then Scott Allen talked about low vibration. And why is it that not everybody is attracted to you? That's a good question. Very good question. So we'll talk about that a little bit too. And maybe I'll even address it a little bit today. All right. So we'll keep going in this. We got about 20 to 35 that we have to do. But let me take care of one today. DSM also made a comment along with the Rising King about how semen retention can actually help you in your purpose in life. So let's kind of examine that a little bit and talk about that one a little bit. So when we talk about semen retention, we're always talking about the idea that you have to look at this as a lifestyle change, and that you're going to get benefits as time goes on when it comes to knowing what you want to do and where you're going to go. Now, it's almost like a battery, right? We talked about the fact that as the battery continues to recharge, you're going to be at full strength. Now, batteries get older, and so it takes a little bit longer to recharge. So you can kind of look at me kind of like as an old battery. And you guys, a lot of you guys between the ages of 25 and 34, which makes up a lot of the population of the channel, you guys are kind of one of those new batteries, right? And so it does take a little more time for me to be able to do this. That's why I'm now experiencing a lot greater changes as I am getting, you know, as I'm getting into this. As I'm closer to 900 days, I see a bigger, like my beard is more fuller than it was before. And certainly my voice has changed. I go back and listen to a couple of the ones that I did way back in August of 2021. And a huge difference change. And I can see that. And the same thing with, you know, and I can't see the glow as well, but people say that. And obviously the attraction is there. Now, as Scott talks about, there are some people that are not going to be attracted to you. And that's going to be the case. Not everybody sees this in you. Now, I think we go back to something I think David had said, David Judah, I think. And I have to, if I'm wrong, please forgive me on that one. But I think David had talked about the fact that you're seeing women seek. Let me double check it just to make sure here. So, who had said this? Because I'm going to do one of these on this. And I'm trying to see which one it was. But I believe that David mentioned. Oh, let's see. Yes, David Judah taught us that God is the person. They're actually seeing God in you. And I believe that could be true. The more and more I think about this, it's very possible that David is right on the mark on this one. And see, what they're doing is, as you're getting closer to God, they're seeing you more. Now, some people will reject that because that's just who they are. And some people will actually get mad. I've had men actually get mad at me because they see something and they just will react. And they may not like what they see. Other people will embrace it and be attracted to it. And a lot of women are attracted to it. But even some women just totally ignore it. Whether or not they're really interested, you know, in anything, you know, then basically they're going to respond back to it. But let's get back to the point that we're kind of talking about here, because I've kind of strayed off a little bit here. We talk about the idea of purpose. So as your strong battery is growing, and as it gets stronger, you're going to kind of map out a plan of your life. And what happens, and we'll talk about this a little bit too in another one, is that you find yourself, as you're on retention, you find yourself getting a lot more opportunities, breaks, things happen to your way, because your attitude, warriors, is so much different. I can't tell you how I feel at this moment after, you know, almost 900 days as compared to what I did 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago when I started. It's just an unbelievable difference, and it's almost like you can do anything. You have that power within you. My only regret is that I did not know this. I didn't try this many years ago, to the point where I was committed. I found myself not really being committed. I guess that would be the bottom line. All those years, I did a little bit here, a little bit there, and I had mild successes. But now that I've done it full blast, it's just amazing to me the differences. And I should have been doing this a long time ago. So I guess that's my kind of, you know, contribution to all you guys and to the world in trying to say, you know, go ahead and do this now when you're younger, and you'll see success a lot earlier. But once again, I was kind of brainwashed, and I was kind of taken in by all the stuff that in society tells you this is what you should be doing. But those movements are changing, and things are changing. People are recognizing the truth in many forms of life. And they recognize, and when it comes to retention, is that, you know, celibacy is not such a bad thing. You know, losing your energy is a good thing. It's not necessarily a bad thing. It's a good thing. So, but going back to the purpose, once you have that battery, and once you're in charge, now you can serve the purpose you're intended for. Now the question then becomes, is why is it easier to form goals, do things, and get, you know, lucky, get it, you know, things happening your way on retention? Well, because your attitude is different, because you're happier, you're like a magnet. They call this the law of attraction. You attract like things to you because that's the energy you're putting out. And the energy you're putting out is a very positive one. It's drawing things in to you. And as you draw things into you, now you're focusing on making those things a lot stronger and desiring those things more. So whether it's relationships you want, whether it's money you want, whether it's forms of joy and happiness, you'll be moving on that stretch, because now you're not spending your time chasing, you know, women around. You're not spending your time focusing on distractions and have anxiety. All those things go away. I can't just really explain it. And we've had so many testimonials. I think I heard one from Leo the other day, and Scott, a lot of people, testimonials, and it's wonderful to hear, guys, that a lot of you guys are, this stuff really, you understand, it affects you, because it's just a great type of thing to know that God has given you everything you need. You don't need all those other things that, you know, science is telling you, even though there's parts of science that I like, because I've done research for years, but the thing is, there's parts of science that are just false. And this whole thing that the world depends on science and is just a malarkey. You know, it's not true. And the thing is that, you know, research is basically as good as the people that are doing research. And the values and the ideas people have it's very difficult to separate those. And so as you talk about this, you're looking at things that are just not right that we've been taught. And I think the idea here is to look at retention and saying, okay, now you are at full go. You're the person, you're the warrior who can actually go out there and make a difference. And that's why we talk about the fact that you can set up goals. So when you talk about all this, your purpose can come to easier because your retention, your focus is better. You're clearer on your ideas. You kind of have an idea of what you want. And as you do this, those things become easier because you're not really kind of wasting a lot of time at the computer, at the TV set, whatever it might be, and you're focusing on this. I mean, there was times when I wanted to go to a TV set and I just kind of moved away from it. Almost like Giovanni says, you know, whenever you get tempted, go for a power walk. Well, go do something, right? Be active, but get away from that situation so you're not tempted. And the thing is that it fits into your goals and patterns. Guys, I can't tell you how different this world is. And for those who are battling this, thinking I shouldn't do this and all that kind of stuff, like I did for many years, and you know, the temptation is too great, I'm going to tell you that you should try it. Give it a shot for a week. Give it a shot. And I know I'm talking to the choir. Most of you know this. But for those who are just listening, who are just not too sure, like I was for 47 years, you have to understand that this is something that is going against all of what the society is telling us to do. But it's something that's the actual truth. And this is where God comes into play. Again, believing in God means you're believing in something you don't see. And once again, that's going against all the so-called truths out there that we hear. When it comes to purposes, the idea is to try to kind of understand, where do you want to go? What do you want to do? Your energy level is going to be so great that it's just going to be a given you're going to be able to accomplish it. It's just a matter of when, not you know, and how, not a matter of if. And that's why we go back to goals. When you have goals, it's important to know short-term goals, long-term goals. So what I would do, if you're struggling with this idea of goals, is get a piece of paper out very simply and just take 1 year and say, okay, where do I want to be in 1 year? Where do I want to be in 5 years? Where do I want to be in 10 years? And you can kind of list the amount of money you want to make. Do you want to be, if you're not married, do you want to be married? Do you want to have kids? Those type of things. And the more you look at that, the more you repeat that in your mind, the more you're focusing on that because of semen retention and your focus is so much greater, you're going to be able to kind of look for opportunities, and all of a sudden opportunities will appear to you. It would seem like it's out of thin air, but it's really not, because you are working now with a force. And let's talk about this for a second. You're working with a force. You're working with God. In my opinion, this is just my opinion, that this is why when Malcolm X talked about this, other people talked about this and going on streaks for 10, 12, 13 years without releasing. It's because they're able to tap into God's power. See, God is actually, my opinion, is within you. This is the word where enthusiasm comes from. I think it's Greek. That you're talking about in enthusiasm within you. God within you. And there's a reason for that. Because God, in my opinion, is in you. Now, you choose to do what you want with that. But as time has gone on, I recognize this is something I need to tap into. And God is the person who created me, so I need to be able to connect with that. And that's the purpose where I'm doing, what I'm going on these streaks, is to move closer to the Lord. And I could see that. I could see that happening. And as you do that, you move further away from this world, more into the spiritual world. And this is why people have taught you that you shouldn't be doing all this. Because the idea is that they don't really want you to get closer to God. The evil one does not want you to get close to God. They want you to get further away from God so they can you can kind of support the evil one. You can worship the evil one. But don't fall for that, because the idea is that, you know, even for a week or so, you feel so much better when you're on the streak. When you're retaining, you feel so much better. And if you can transmute it, even better than that. And those things you learn over time. So the idea is that you can create goals and you can kind of look at success as you go through. So great comment from both the Rising King. Thank you, Rising King, and DSM. Once again, this is a lifestyle change, my friends. This is something that happens over a period of time, and you have to keep working at it. Now, it's taken me now 2.5 years to get back to kind of normal levels for you, and I'm 61, so you guys are a lot younger. So you guys should be able to get there pretty quickly and keep moving along. So, guys, thank you so much. I just wanted to kind of do one on a Saturday morning when I'm sitting here waiting. And I'm going to kind of move on the rest of the day and keep active. You guys, I hope you do the same. You guys have a great weekend. I'll try to do one tomorrow if I can to catch up a little bit on my the list here. Please keep sending me ideas. Keep sending me things we can talk about. And you guys have a great day. And remember, every day is a new day to a warrior and a wise warrior. God bless you guys and battle on.